The sun is out, so am I, and I'm headed to my favorite spot to have a morning cup of coffee. Good morning, or almost afternoon-ish, but it's still morning, so I still have my cup of coffee. When I finish this, then I switch to my water. But welcome to this little chit-chat, and I am Crystal from Homemaking on the Homestead, and today I just have a few questions to ask for anybody that would be interested in sharing, and a few thoughts to share with you. That's why I call it a chit-chat, coffee with Crystal type video. Right now, I guess one of the things that has been on my mind a lot is that the state of our country, our world is kind of just uneasy. It's not comfortable. And I try to think there's a lot of things we don't have control over. There's a lot of things that there is nothing that we can do about. There are things that we can do. And what that is different for, you know, every person. But I like to look at what is in my realm, what's my domain, and what are the things that I can do for my family, basically my husband and I, and even children too, if they would ever need help or that I would have things for, be able to help them out. We would be able to help them out. But my main thought has been on my pantry. I wanted to do a better job at preparing my pantry. I've done a few things. I canned a bunch of beans recently and shared those with my daughter. If you missed that video, I'll post it up here so that you can take a look at that. I've done a little jam and things like that, just because we do like having those things on hand, and I enjoy the homemade versus the store-bought. And I am planning to do meat. I have a good amount of meat in my freezer that's taking up space, and I just thought if I could get that canned and on the shelf, not only would it allow me to have easy meals to prepare from it, but it would also free up some freezer space. And I think it being on canned and on the shelf might be a little bit better shelf life. I'm not exactly sure. I know meat will last a while in the freezer, but it does start to deteriorate after a certain point. And I do actually really need my freezer space, so for other things. So those are some of the things that I am going to be doing. But one of my biggest questions that I have now that it is my husband and I, how big of a pantry do I keep? How much food should I stock? How much is necessary for two people? And for what time limit, what time frame? You know, should I have a month's worth of some food? Should I have 6 months, a year? I do have bulk goods, beans, rice, that type of thing, flour, sugar. And I do have canned goods. When I had my family at home, I used to keep an extensive pantry that was very large. I used to buy food in 25 and 50 pound bags, the bulk type foods. I had lots of canned goods. I did a lot of canning. And all my canned goods, whether they were mine or what I bought at the store, I would rotate to keep a supply. I'm sure if times got really difficult, we could have lived easily, for at least a year on what I had canned and what I had on the shelf. It may not have been the best diet, but if things were difficult, we would have been okay for a good amount of time. Today I don't have anywhere near that. At that time I was feeding 10 people. We had 8 children and then the two of us. And so it was important for me to have a good supply of food. And also we are probably 45 minutes to an hour from a major grocery store, so you just don't run out and buy things. So it was always important for me to make sure I had food on the shelf ready to go, or bulk supplies that I could create whatever I wanted. One of my questions to you today is, if you have a pantry and you are thinking of prepping wise, how much time do you prep for? What kind of things do you keep on hand? And how many people are you prepping for as well? It's so much different for just two people. I find it a little bit, confusing at times. That's not the right word. I find it a struggle at times because I realize how little food just two people eat. My brain still wants to plan for 10 people, and that's just not a reality, which is why I trimmed my pantry down as much as possible. And then when we started going through all of the virus issues and things, I was like, would it be better if my pantry was just a little bit stocked more so than what it was? And I decided that, yeah, I think that would be a good idea, that I should probably start working on that. My thought at this point is to increase canned goods and dry goods and do some extra canning, perhaps, especially over the summer, if I get anything, a good deal on fresh vegetables and potatoes or carrots, or things that might routinely go on sale, is to turn that into canned food. And so I'm just curious from you all, what do you do? Do you have a pantry that's well prepped? Would you like to see your pantry prepped better? And what are the types of foods that you most like to keep on hand? I've always found that keeping the dry goods on hand is better than the products. For example, it's much better to have a lot of flour and yeast and baking powder and baking soda, sugar, salt, because from that you can make your own bread, and it takes up less space than having a freezer full of bread. I had just mentioned potatoes. I'm hoping to see some good deals on potatoes later in the fall, because I would like to can those. I currently buy a lot of frozen potatoes products, I think mainly because, I probably am just getting a little bit lazy, that I don't have to watch the budget as much. But again, those take up space. They have limited amount of time. If I had cubed potatoes canned on the shelf, I could do with those just about everything that I do already with my own potatoes. I could roast them, I could turn them into casseroles, I could mash them. You can't really mash canned potatoes. That'd be the one thing I couldn't do. I could do a lot and have a lot of meal preps ready to go. And so I thought, well, that would be budget friendly, and it would be a good thing to have on hand. So I'm just going to kind of wait patiently and see what I can find as far as deals on potatoes. And it would certainly, my goodness, be so cheap to do it that way as opposed to what I do. I know that there's a lot of ways that I could trim my budget, and so I have also started looking at those types of things in relation to the pantry prepping. I will have to say, as this video started, it was sunny. I'm looking up now and it's getting more and more gray. And after having heard the weather report yesterday, it wouldn't be surprising to me if it started to sprinkle and rain. So I should probably wrap this video up before I get I get wet and all my stuff gets wet out here. But hey, I got to be out and enjoy a little bit of sunshine, and that always makes me a happy girl. In any case, thank you for watching this video today. Thank you for coming and having a chat and visiting with me today. I appreciate you all very much. I'm really enjoying my YouTube life and the people that I'm getting to meet, and the comments I'm getting. I appreciate them and I enjoy them a lot. If you like this video, could you give it a like? And if you haven't subscribed to my channel and you like my content, would you consider subscribing? And that is all for today's video. I will see you all next time. So, bye-bye.